All right, we are back in the booth, and we are going to do one of these RK55 rock crawlers from Lure Build. And what I'm going to do it in is I'm going to do it in a transparent crawl pattern that I like to paint. So we're actually going to do it a little differently. We're going to actually use the Insane Custom Stencils tape crawl for this one. And this is a very good stencil. If you're not familiar with it, I have done a video in the past on it, but I'm going to use it on this one right here. So we're going to lock this down, because you got to actually take, and the cool thing about this stencil is you actually stick it on. So you actually stick it onto the lure, and then you actually do your taping. So we're going to take this off gently. It's not, these are pretty thick stencils. I don't know what material Rush uses on these, but it's nice. You can actually, and these are reusable also. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it out of this, and we'll do it. So we'll start here and just see how it goes. And just remember, it's just like any other stencil, you really want to start very low on it. And this one is going to be it's got a lot of curve to it, so we're going to have to get it going here, and then we can get it to stay. I'm going to have to pull it off. I really need to start up here first. Press it on really good, and then we'll go ahead and start spraying this. Let me get a glove on here. And what we'll do, I'll get this thing back into focus, because I'm going to have to do this one. I'm going to take this and set it up here. We'll move it up here. And then we'll come on back in so you can see. Alright, so let me get some black in the gun, give it a little shake. We got this on low pressure. Probably about 15. I'll give it a test here. And that's good. So then what we're going to do is you can hold it really any way you like. It's wanting to. This bait is small. It's not a big bait. And I've just got to get where I can just hold the bait without knocking my stencil off. So I'm probably going to hold it in reverse. So all I'm going to do is, let me get this camera angle a little bit better. I don't have it the way I want it. Back it up a little bit. Alright. So what we're going to do, we're going to take it. And all you're wanting to do with this is just keep it on the stencil and let the overspray go over. And we'll come back just to make sure we didn't miss. Okay. And I'll go ahead and heat set that really fast. And we'll be right back. All right, so what we'll do now is we'll go ahead and just take it off. And that's what you get. It gives it a cool, nice looking little pattern. And we'll take this and put it back on the piece of paper here. It's kind of like a wax piece of paper, and it just keeps it sticky. And then I'm going to take a little miniature wing ding, and then we'll just run our lines up. We're going to get a sponge out here to hold it up. Because this is a very tiny bait. You just got to kind of get it managed. I'll go ahead and spray the eye so I can see the bait a little better when you're doing these ghosts. All right, so what we'll do now is I have the miniature wing ding, and what we'll do is we'll go ahead and put our crawl lines on it. And the good thing about the stencil is it already gives you the markers for it. So all you have to do is just line it up. And there's no right or wrong way to do this. You can line it up however way you like. And just spray more on the stencil. And let the overspray come up. And it puts your crawl shell on there. Gives it a real unique look. And like I said, it tells you where to put your shell lines. So it works out really good in how you get it done. And on this one, we'll go ahead and do some, I'm gonna do this a little darker because it went up by the gill plate a little bit, and I just wanna make it a little bit darker. There we go. And then I'll just take a mottled stencil and put a little bit on the face. It's a really little bait, so I'm gonna use the small one. I'm not gonna use a big one for this. Flip it around. Do this one a little bit more. Okay, and that really gives it a neat look. So we'll heat set that and we'll go to the next step. All right, so we've got that dried off, and what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna put just a little bit of this model on top. Well, we'll leave that alone. We'll just do it in red. We'll do the stencil work first. So let's grab this other side. And like I said, about the stencils, you have a left and a right side. So that's kind of nice. So we'll take it off. And you can get these at insanecustomstencils.com. Russ is a great guy. So let me take this out again, just temporarily, until we get this done. And I'll try to get this in the camera where we can see it. And like I said, this is a very small bait. And it kind of bevels down at the bottom. So it's going to be, this is a little tough one to do. So we're going to get it on here. And I'll hold it with my left. You just want to make sure it's straight. And then we'll just run it down. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to take it. And we're just going to run, let the overspray. So we'll let that dry just for a second and get our stand back out where you can actually see it. And I'll just take this and we'll just take it off. And you have a pretty much a perfect crawl pattern on there. I love these stencils. I hadn't used them in a while. I just have so much stuff. I tell you, it's just hard to get everything out and where I can actually see everything. But these are fantastic stencils.
So let's get it back in the holder and we'll flip it upside down like I do, but you don't have to do it this way. You can, you can just lay it on the, I'm just trying to put it on here where y'all can see it. And then I'm just gonna take the wing thing, and you can, like I said, if you put a little bit of acetone on in between it, I mean, what I really like to do is be able to see when my paint's laying on it. So you just take a little cotton ball like I just did there, wipe it off, and it's good to go. And then you can just stick it on, because it gives you the points, like I said, it gives you the points of where you're gonna run your shell lines, and just let the overspray do the work. Sorry about that, guys. Just does a really good job. We'll do two more. Do one more. And that's done. So then what we'll do is we'll let that, we'll heat set that really quick, and then we'll come in and do some modeling work over top of that. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we still have some black in the gun, and we're gonna go ahead and do the eye in, and then we'll go ahead and do some modeling on this. All right, we'll heat set that, and then we'll do a little work on the bottom of the bait. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna move to the next step, and we'll go ahead and do a little bit of work on this bottom, and we're gonna use our trusty Louisville crawl stencil for this one. Just remember to line it up with the, on the hook hanger. That does a good job every time. Okay, so we're gonna get all that heat setted, and then we're gonna do a little work on the top of this. All right, so what we'll do now is we'll go onto the top of the bait, and I'm gonna use some golden red light. We'll give it a quick shake and spin around on the 4E's mixer. Get a little bit in the gun. Need a whole lot. I'm actually using my HP B Plus today with a 0.2 needle in it. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the red and we're just gonna go over the top. We'll have to do this in a few layers. When you don't have a sealer on top or a top coat, it makes it a little bit different. So we'll have to do a little bit, then heat set it. And the same thing again, put it on real light. Don't worry about overdoing it right off the bat. We'll heat set that and we'll hit another coat on it. All right, so what we're gonna do now is just get another coat on the top of the red, darken it up. Okay, that's plenty dark. We'll clean our gun out, and then we'll go to the next step. Just get a light coat on this bill. Get the sides. I'm not going to do anything near that line tie. Stay away from that. Get a little more on here. I'll hit this side. It just clears it right on up. Then we'll get this bottom of the bait. Transparent baits look really good. They turn out really nice. Just want to make sure we get it all. Get a little bit more on there. Like I said, it's not a big bait. I actually thought they were a little bigger than this, but they're nice. Just double check and go over everything good. You don't want to pull it out of your light box and then you have spots you've missed. It's better just to take your time with this part of it and make sure you get it completely done. Okay. So what we'll do is I'm going to put it in the box and I'll show you the final results. All right, and we've just taken it out of the box, and here are the final results. Turned out really good. Transparent crawl. New RK55 from Lure Build. Turned out pretty good. Used the new tape crawl stencil from Insane Custom Stencils, so if you like the video, hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell notification so you know when I have upcoming videos. And like I always say, I'll catch you next time. Thanks.